don't know what's going on my library card. Libby won't let me use it. Do I have an overdue book? Y'all, did they lock me on my Libby? Verify your library card, right? Look, y'all, invalid card. What? I literally used this 2 days ago. Like, quit playing like you don't know me. I need to get this figured out today. I can't live like this. I need my card.
Continue for 1.5 miles.
Okay. I put my hair down for the evening parties. So it's my birthday eve. I have a little bit of a book haul for you. I have 6 books that I'm going to show you and talk to you about what I know about the book. I haven't read any of these yet. Well, some of them I've started to read and I just didn't finish. So I'll tell you just what I know from about the book. But the first one I actually got out of a little library today, and it is Beloved by Toni Morrison. If you've been on here for a second, you know that I already own this book. I do. But the book that I own is the first edition, and it is from my grand uncle. So that one is like special. You can't really read that. It's like a shrine. This one is the Vintage International edition. I love the spines, but the covers are so lazy to me. Like, it's literally cursive on a solid color. The next one is Among Flowers by Jamaica Kincaid. I've heard a lot about this author in general. This is the book that I wanted to start with from this author, even though I want to read quite a few of the books from her backlist. This is one I want to start with because it's a little bit of a memoir and it's travel writing, and it's a gorgeous cover. This is another one I got today, and one that I'll probably read next. Like, this may be my next read. Definitely probably gonna be the first book that I read from this stack, and it is Feel Free by Zadie Smith. This is essays. I haven't really read any Zadie Smith at all, but I have listened to so many of her interviews. She is absolutely brilliant to me. Biggest inspiration as a writer, as a creative person, as a human in general, just her thoughts and the way that she like constructs her sentences when she's just normally talking. I want to be her so bad. I also own White Teeth by Zadie Smith. That is her debut novel, right? But I think I want to start with her essays. I really do. She read a snippet of this book specifically in one of the interviews that I watched, and it was phenomenal. I just want an extra peek into Zadie Smith's brain, and I think this book will give me that. Then I have a book that I've had my eye on for a while, probably all year. A Tale for the Time Being by Ruth Ozeki. This one is a split narrative, I want to say. One narrative is Ruth, and one narrative is this girl named Now, who's like writing this diary about her grandmother, whom she loves very much, before she commits suicide. And then Ruth finds Now's journal like washed up on the beach or something. I've heard that it like has a lot of commentary on time and the present and the future, which is why the girl's name is Now. Stellar wordplay, by the way. Then I have another book that I've had my eye on literally all year. If an Egyptian Cannot Speak English by Noor Naga. I know it has some commentary on class and an oppressive regime and like power dynamics and romantic relationships, because the book follows the main character as she like falls in love with the love interest and the way in which their relationship becomes quickly dark and violent. But I've also heard that this book breaks people's brain in a good way. Last but not least, we have a book that y'all have seen me read a little bit from the library. Monstrillo by Gerardo Simano Cordova. I already read the first like three chapters of this. Love it. I needed to annotate it, which is why I was like, okay, I'm gonna buy it. I wanted to show you a few of the things I got for my birthday. As you saw on this vlog, I had a little surprise birthday party. I did not know that that was gonna be going on. Well, my mima gave me like a recipe book and some highlighters and a candle. So I got the two limited edition glossiers, the hot cocoa and the cookie butter. I think the cookie butter is out of stock now. It smells like cookie butter and hot cocoa. It smells so good, and it doesn't smell like weird. Like, y'all know some scented stuff smells kind of weird. That's not how this is. My dog is barking. And it's not very sticky. It's not too tinted.
which is what I wanted. I just wanted a very light tint. I also got Ana Luisa Tia hoop earrings. I got them in small, not mini. Of course, I had to get another papier journal because I'm obsessed. My cousin got me Open Water by Caleb Nelson, which if I had to pick a favorite book from the year, it would be this book. And he wrote me a little note at the back. I love this book. I love, love, love this book. Part of my Mima's gift was this furry bag. My big gift, I guess. Well, not I guess. It's definitely my big gift. Was a record player. Oh, sorry. I also got a calla lily plant. She's beautiful and she's yellow. Then I got, like I was telling you, a record player. I literally spent like hours looking through my papa's vinyl collection and playing music. It was so fun. And me and my papa are gonna go vinyl shopping very soon, so stay tuned for that because it's probably gonna be in a monthly reading diary or something. Okay. But also my papa gifted me one of his vinyls. Like, this is gonna be a staple in my vinyl collection. I'm actually probably gonna cry about it once I finish recording also. Just being honest. But it is the Quincy Jones Walking in Space album. And my papa even put a little note in Sharpie on the vinyl. And I kind of want to cry. I kind of